Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. So today's video is the start of my Halloween makeup series. So over the next couple of weeks I'm going to be showing you guys some really simple and easy to do Halloween makeup looks so that you guys can create these at home. And our first Halloween makeup look is going to be this really simple but really pretty butterfly eye makeup look. I love this look, it was so much fun to do. It's not perfect, it's my first ever butterfly but I'm still so proud of it. So if you guys would like to see how I created this look, make sure you keep watching. To begin with, I'm going to be taking my Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Freeze, and I just basically wet my spoolie and applied some of the product to the spoolie and then just run the product through your brows. It's really easy to use, it leaves your brows looking incredible, just gives you that really nice laminated look and they stay in place all day. I'm then going to go in with the Plouise base and I'm just taking this really small peaches and cream brush, and as you guys can see I'm just making sure that the Plouise base goes right up to my brows and that it's all blended out nicely. I wanted to start with this brush because I didn't want a really harsh line underneath my brows, I wanted it to look really soft and pretty, so rather than carving out my brows I just kind of like blended it out underneath my brows, if that makes sense. I'm then taking another brush just to pat the rest of the Plouise base out, and I'm bringing this right out to my temple as far out as possible because obviously this is where the actual butterfly makeup look is going to be happening, like a lot of it is going to be towards the temple and the hairline, so you do want to make sure that you are dragging that primer out as far as you possibly can. And then I'm just going to make sure that I'm getting my inner corner as well, as this just creates a little bit more highlight. I'm going to brighten up my eyes and make sure everything is nice and primed, ready to go. Next up, I'm going in with the NYX Wonder Pencil in the shade Light. And as you guys can see, I am just mapping out the general shape of the butterfly wings. I just wanted to make sure that they were matching and that they weren't wonky at all. So I thought it was best to just map these out to make sure they're as perfect as I could make them, rather than going in and doing it freehand with the paints and whatnot. I got some reference pictures from online, so I just like found pictures of butterflies and then also some other butterfly makeup looks that people had done as well, and then I just kind of made my own shape. A lot of them were like a full butterfly but I just wanted to do like the butterfly eyes. Make sure that when you are doing this part that you are referring back to your first eye just so that you make sure that they are perfectly symmetrical. Using the Plouise coloured base in the shade Vivid Violet, I'm now filling in the butterfly wing, just the whole entire butterfly wing. And to apply this, I am using a Real Techniques, oh, I can't remember the name of the brush. It's something like a, oh my god, what is it? Detailed conceal brush, that's one. I'm just applying this to the whole shape of the butterfly, just to make sure that I had nice sharp lines and that I was happy with the shape as well. And then taking a winged liner brush, I'm just going to extend out one of the parts of the butterfly wing. I really didn't need to do that because I ended up going over it with black anyway, so there was literally no point. But if I was to do this again, I'd probably make this part a little bit thicker just so that you could see the purple a little bit more. But it still turned out really pretty in the end and I was really happy with the shape. I'm now going to go in to the NYX coloured palette and I'm going to take a very similar shade to the Vivid Violet Plouise eye base and I'm just going to press this all over the first half of my eye and then I'm just going to do the same on the other side as well. And I just wanted to make sure that I'd set the base properly, I didn't want it to smudge or start to crease or anything like that, so just made sure that was nice and set. And then I'm going to go in with a deeper purple shade. I'm sorry that was a little bit out of focus. And I'm going to apply that to the outer corner of my eye, but I'm not going to take it the full way to the rest of the wing. Then just taking a fluffy blending brush, I'm just going to blend those two colours together. I then went in with the Morphe 12P palette with the dark purple shade, and I'm just filling in the rest of the butterfly shape, and again just taking a blending brush, just making sure that all those colours blend seamlessly together. I wanted the butterfly to look like a really pretty purple ombre, so going from light to dark. I'm then just doing the same process on the other eye, making sure that purple is down, and then blending out those edges. Next up, I'm taking the Maybelline Lasting Drama Liquid Liner in the shade black. This is the waterproof matte version, and I'm just really gently and very neatly outlining the butterfly shape on the eyes. As you can see, I did leave a gap at the inner corner of my eye. It's just because I don't think it'd suit my eye shape. You could do a really cute like inner corner flick, if you guys know what I mean. So I'm just taking my time doing this. It was quite a delicate process, so you do want to make sure that you are taking your time and not rushing yourself. Also, if you're using liquid liner, it can take a little while to dry down, so you want to make sure that you are not looking up at any point because it might transfer. So just made sure that I was looking down, and yeah, just making sure that that stuff wasn't transferring. I then went in and made certain parts of the wing thicker. So for example, the actual wings of the butterfly, I made sure that they were a lot thicker. And I've then gone on just with the same product, and I'm just drawing a couple of little lines, as you guys can see here. This is just to make the butterfly wing look a little bit more realistic. If you were to look at a real butterfly wing, they always have these like black lines that run through the wing. To add more definition to the wings, I went in with some of the Snazzeroo white paint on a dotting tool. This is just like a nail dotting tool from my nail kit, but you can buy these anywhere, they're super cheap. And I just added these to the outer portions of the wing. I'm then going back in with the same liquid liner and applying a really, really thin line across my upper lash line. Next up, I'm moving on to base products, and I'm going to start by priming my face using the Nip and Fab Primer. This is so hydrating. If you guys have dry skin, you need to give this a go. And of course, I'm just being mindful of the butterfly wings as well when applying any base products. I'm then going to take Loreal True Match Foundation and apply this all over my face. Again, being very mindful of the butterfly wings. If you guys remember from earlier on in the video, we did drag out the Plouise base to our temples, so you don't need to worry about applying any foundation too close to the wings because you'll already have that bit of coverage off the Plouise base. And I believe I used the shade True Ivory in this foundation as well. To apply my foundation, I'm going in with the Real Techniques buffing brush, and I'm just really gently buffing this in to my skin. I then go in with my So Eco sponge and just make sure there are no brush marks, no lines. I want everything to be nice and flawless, and this also just helps push the foundation into your skin and give you a more natural finish. To conceal, I'm going to use the Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer, and I'm just applying this to the portions of my face that need it. So the very inner corner of my eyes, my forehead, my nose, my cupid's bow, and my chin. So I apply it down the center portion of my face just to add a little bit more highlight and also a little bit more coverage, and then underneath my eye just to give me coverage. This is where I have major problems. I've got very dark circles, so this is just going to help cover them up. And I'm using the point on my sponge to make sure that I'm getting a really precise application. To set my face, I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder in the shade 102. To get under my eyes, I'm just using a really small stippling brush. And then to apply the powder to the rest of my face, I'm just going in with a larger powder brush. To bronze and contour up my face, I'm going to go in with this Nip and Fab palette. I'm just going to start off by using this shade down here, using an angled face brush. And I'm just going to do that on both sides of my face, just add a little bit more color and warmth into my skin. I used a little bit of the same bronzer to bronze up my forehead as well. I then moved on to blush, and I used the MAC Bushbaby blush. Looks really, really beautiful with the purple makeup look. For highlighter, I wanted to use something with a purple sheen to it. So I went in with the Ofra x Nikki Tutorials Cloud 9 Highlighter. I'm just applying this all over my face where I usually apply my highlighter. Then I also just added some to my brow bone as well, just to finish off the eye look. And then also a little bit on my inner corner as well. Then went in with some mascara, and I'm using the Thick and Fast Mascara from Soap and Glory. This is my favourite mascara in the world. I talk about this all the time. It's really good, super cheap, and it's nice to find a really good drugstore mascara. To line my lips, I went in with the Barry M Toast Lip Liner, and then for lipstick, I went in with a Smashbox Lip Palette using the shade Audition. I'm not sure whether you can buy this shade separately or whether they still do this palette, but this colour is gorgeous. It's really nice and creamy, very comfortable on the lips. I then went in and applied my false lashes, and I decided to add some of this pigment from Ilha Máscara. It's called Static, and I applied this to my brow bone and also my cheekbone, just to add a little bit more highlight to these areas. This pigment also has the most stunning purple reflect, so I thought it would look really nice with this makeup look. And here we have the finished look. I'm so happy with how it turned out, considering this was my first ever butterfly eye makeup look. I'm really happy and I'm really pleased. You would be able to recreate this look using any colours at all. Instead of using a conventional bronzer, you could go in with like a purple blush or an eyeshadow and just create a little bit more of a colourful look. But hopefully you guys enjoyed my first ever Halloween tutorial. There will be more coming, so make sure you guys like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye everyone!